And we're now going to hear from another storyteller, Humera Asanola. Humera is a self-made success. She balances being a mother, an author, an academic, and successful entrepreneur. And she's going to share with us her journey of how she first discovered her own connection to this community by running for political office. An interesting experience, I am sure. So please welcome Humera to our Story Cafe stage.
Thank you, Mark, and thank you to all the participants who have come over here to share their stories and those who have already shared, like I'm sharing right now. And thank you to all of you for coming over here and hearing our stories. I forgot completely. Anyways, I have been living in Coquitlam for about 13 years. And I immigrated about 22 years from Pakistan to Vancouver. I had a very comfortable lifestyle in a third world country, but when I came here, I had a very humble beginning in a first world country. I had to go through a lot of struggles, a lot of hardships, and a lot of adjustment issues. But bit by bit, I gathered myself, and I came to the place where I am right now. Now when I look back and I see all the struggles and I say it was really good for me because it shaped me. It made me what I am now. It built my character, my personality. And the one thing important that I realized from all those experiences was nothing in life is as important as relationships. And today my story is also about my relationship with Coquitlam. How I build that relationship here. It all began in 2011 when I decided to run for the school board trustee in municipal election. Coming from the Indian subcontinent part of the world, I could compare the education system over there and here and could see what is good over here and what needs improvement. And most of the time I would discuss this with my husband. And so he saw my enthusiasm, and when the election time came, he suggested me that why don't you run for school board trustee? And I had challenges, so I said, why not? So I went to the registrar, she gave me a big binder to read, and I read it, and I felt, yeah, this is a job I can do. So I got myself nominated for the election. I was the only independent candidate. The rest were all incumbents already held the office. Then I realized that I need marketing tools. I need a website, I need flyers, and I didn't have money. But luckily my husband is an IT person, so he helped me develop the website. My children helped me a little bit. And while I was trying to absorb all what I've gotten myself into, I started receiving phone calls, emails that to attend the debates, to attend this, and then I received a phone call from the mayor as well, inviting me to have a cup of tea with him because he doesn't know me. Now this was all too much for me because I was not ready for that. My focus was mainly to how I can be useful to someone, to the community. I didn't think about that, and coming into this kind of a limelight was not my agenda at all. But hey, I was in. So I said, okay. I went to see the mayor, had a cup of tea with him. And first thing he asked me was, Humera, how many people do you know? And I was surprised because I was not ready for this question. Why does it matter? So I told him, I don't know. I'm maybe 50 or less. And he gave me a blank look and said, it's kind of like an awakening question for me. He asked me then, how do you expect to win, Humera? And I looked at him again and I said, I really don't know because I didn't even think about that, Mr. Mayor. And then I tried to tell him about a little of my family background. My forefathers had been all very actively involved in the Indian country's politics. So maybe he could see some silver lining that I have acquired those political genes. Maybe I can be a politician. And he looked at me and said, "Humaira, you're not a politician." So overall, I had a good time, and he even put my brochures in his office to help me with my campaign. But I came home with a heavy heart. For the first time, I realized that it's not easy. It's a rough ride. I can easily be crushed. It's too high a mountain for me to climb and stick a flag. I don't even know many people. I don't even know 50 people. Maybe he's right that I'm not a politician. But I also knew that I'm not a quitter. So I kept going. I said, okay, let's see. So I attended the debates. I even went on this TV speech, where every time I was forgetting the speech, I'm not a paper person. And luckily, I also got some volunteers. They volunteered to distribute my flyer in some of the pockets. They came themselves. Even one person wanted to make my campaign video. I was honored, and I was indebted to them for that. And I myself would stand outside the train stations, bus stops at 5 o'clock in the morning, distributing my homemade flyers, and even to grocery stores. Then my children, my husband, we would all stand at the corners of the roads with the sign saying, "Vote for me, vote for Mama." And those signs were really not made, were not custom made. My children and I, we made it from sticks and cardboards. We didn't have much budget money for the campaign. So we spent our own hard-earned money, about $840. And so right off the bat, I knew that I'm bound to lose. It's a tough call, and I'm not going to win. I didn't have the support of the union. I didn't have the support of teachers. I didn't have any bankroll, nothing, no support. So I knew that I'm not going to win. But okay, let's keep going again. The final day came, the counting began. My family, we were all glued in front of the TV. And I was just concerned at that time was, what if I get no votes at all? Zero. Then what will happen? I mean, I was thinking how embarrassing that would be. But then they announced that I've got one vote. And my husband looked at me and said, "That's me." I said, "Thank God for that." So then I got 2, 3, 4 more votes, and I said, okay, I've got some in my pocket. And then 10, 20, 100, 200, 1,000, we were all jumping up and down. How come I got so many votes? But the counting was not stopping there. It went on, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, and stopped at 4,550 votes. Half the number of those who won. And do you think I was dancing at that time? No. I was stunned, and I was just thinking, how did it happen? I didn't know many people, and how can I get, I didn't have any support either. How can I get so many votes? And then tears started flowing through my eyes because I knew who gave me the votes. The ordinary common people like you and me. They gave me the vote, they entrusted their votes towards me without knowing me at all. They just saw my campaign, my speeches, and they trusted their valuable vote towards me. That was very precious for me. I did not win the election, but I didn't lose either. Because in a sense, I was a winner. I had gained the trust of my community, and that is when I built my relationship with my Coquitlam. And Coquitlam became a part of me, and I became Coquitlam's part. I love you, Coquitlam, and I will be there for you. Thank you.